This is two shy guys a mile high, and we're gonna run it like three. Certified on the track. Yo, 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 we are back. This 2CGMH, two shy guys a mile high. You're back in the place to be. It's your boy P-Wil, Mr. Feel Good.
It's your boy WB. Come fly with me, but you can't fly for free.
And it's your boy Al-Diga, the architect, still building together, man. And that's been a thing, bro. This whole season six, we've been in it, man. Just together and flexible. We talked about that, just how to figure this crap out, man. It's been interesting, you know. Been a lot of growth this year, man. A lot of growth. And I don't know about y'all, man, but it was two long years of just being cooped up in the crib and having to do something, man. I just been putting my head into the books, man, you know, and just trying to learn and stuff and get into the entrepreneurial spirit, because, you know, it was just a moment of solitude, right? We had to all be home and just sit. It was no go out. It was no, I'm going to meet you at the club this weekend and get, you know, to kick it, because this whole week has been crazy at work. You know what I'm saying?
It's still no club for me.
It's still real. We still pandemic pimping out here.
But I mean, it's at least it's a little bit more open. You know, folks are like, I get how to maneuver throughout this stuff, but I think that's what's been crazy for me, man. I know we were talking about it off podcast, just how uncomfortable, man, this has been, a lot of this stuff, because ain't nobody had to just been in people's face like all day, every day, and just, you know, really restricted with, you know, how you can move. And so, like, I appreciate y'all being, you know, real flexible and really understanding and
that's real
and growing, man.
I know on the last episode we posed the question, like, how did you cope through COVID? What was your coping mechanism? I just like to bring that up just to see, like, you know, as time progressed, I know we may have talked about, like, how we're getting through, but now it's a time where things are opening back up. Things are no mask mandates, getting back to normal, getting back to regular schedule program. Mm-hmm. We've been sticking to the script, continuing to do that. But, like, how'd you cope with now? How do you cope with now this new form of life and getting back into the mix and understanding things? Like, are you comfortable? Are you not comfortable?
Yeah, well, let me talk to you. I know, Dub, you want to get up in here, man, and talk about you as well.
Man, it's a podcast, man. Anybody fair, talking, fair.
I didn't know if it was supposed to be me, but I didn't want to just be hogging. So, I mean, but since we talked about it, how I coped with just, like I said, just digging in, bro, like really trying to stay focused on what I can control. And now coming out of that stuff, like the opportunities are coming. Like it's crazy because, like we said, sticking to the script, we stay diligent, but being able to stay home and really focus on what you really want to do. Like a lot of people haven't really had a chance to do that. You know what I'm saying? And so I just really just try to stay in my books. I try to stay off a lot of social media, you know what I'm saying? Because it's going crazy over on there.
Man, for real. So, you're always seeing something new on the news every day. You can't just get enveloped in that stuff, man, especially because you see a lot of negativity. But I always ask myself, like, is it just nowadays we see the negativity and, like, the world's been messed up and we just haven't been able to see it as instantly as we can now? Like, what's been changing in that aspect? Or, like, has the world been shitty, like, throughout? But now we just got the chance to see it because everybody, you know what I'm saying, you know, are we opening our eyes to it, or is it just like now, like, we're sitting back and realizing it more because we had the chance to actually sit down and see this since we've been in to understand, like, what's been going on? Because like you said, lives have been, everything that was on the go kind of shut down and stopped, but in the meantime stuff was still happening.
Yeah.
And now you got more time to actually look at it and get caught up in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, man, for me, my coping mechanism was just staying busy, like having stuff to do, you know, working on businesses, working on, like, hustles, still working, you know what I'm saying, the gig, entrepreneur spirit.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying, just all of that, and just time really don't stop, man. It's, you got to continue to go. And during this whole COVID time, I think that was just realization. It's like, you going to let this stop you from doing what you got to do to provide and to, under, you know, saying to progress. And mm-hmm. I feel like staying busy was just like my way of not getting, you know, caught up in everything that's going on. Because we understand you can only control your own controllables.
Right. Yep.
And that's probably the way I got through the whole coping mechanism with COVID.
Yeah. I would echo the same thing. I would take it a little bit further. I don't necessarily think it's about being busy, but it was more so being intentional, depending on what I was doing. So intentional about what skills I was trying to learn, intentional about what my next moves I wanted to make, intentional about what books that I wanted to read, intentional about growth.
Yeah.
So I think all those things play a factor into just coping and being intentional too at the same time of being reflective and realizing how I feel, seeing what's going on from the outside in so you can make those adjustments. But a lot of that just led to me being uncomfortable at some points and times. And then at the same point, part of being uncomfortable is doing things, getting out of your comfort zone. And then as you continue to do that for the things that you want to do intentionally, you start to become more comfortable.
Yeah.
I would say the hard part right now for me is making sure I don't go back to old habits or creep back into old behaviors that don't necessarily serve.
You know?
It's so easy to do.
Definitely.
It's so easy to do because even, you know, when I'm sparring, when I'm doing stuff for boxing, I think I have it down about staying calm, you know, keeping my punches tight, knowing how to block, when to move, what moves to make. But in the height of the moment and when you're against your opponent, and that opponent could be most of the time yourself, and in life in general, you just start to get frantic and you forget about all the training you had and you start to revert back to old things,
comfortable ways. No, real talk. No, and that's where you gotta just keep kind of putting yourself in those uncomfortable situations, right? Not to throw yourself off deep end with no you know life preserver or whatever, but having plans to kind of stretch your imagination, stretch your limiting beliefs, because that's what it is. It's just like, oh man, I can't start that business.
It's growth within experience,
bro. But then when you get it, you're gonna fail because you don't know what questions to ask, right? But when you start asking questions, failing, getting back up, you get back up with the lean mentality. Yo, next time, this and this, I'm not gonna do it, but I'm going to keep going. What worked? Bam, bam. And so you start to get momentum because you didn't give up, first of all. And then you realize in the moment, like, all you can control is you. Like you said, P-Dub. Like, all you can do is control you and be intentional. Like, I think that's the difference maker, right? Like okay, I do want to spend my time more effectively. Okay, well, what are you doing to do that? You know, do you have a schedule? Do you have something that's going to keep you accountable to yourself? And that's the hardest part, because when you sit with yourself, you know, the little damn, that cookie looking good, I ain't nobody looking,
I can
sneak that cookie though, but I'm trying to get the six pack abs though, so you know the process, but you gonna, you know what I'm saying, put yourself in these uncomfortable situations. But as you do it more, right, follow me, then that cookie becomes less of a distraction. You're like, I get that cookie out of here. You know what I'm saying? Because you can say that temptation. You can
do some scenario planning too. I think that is something that I could do a little bit better about as well too. You could put yourself in the situation and say, okay, I'm Will. I open up the pantry. I see a cookie and it looks like I really want that. What am I going to do, right? And you could start putting yourself to
those visualizations.
Yeah, those visualizations.
Absolutely.
Scripting that you can have. So the thought could be more automatic on the positive side. Where if you see the cookie, you're not automatically thinking, I just got to eat the cookie. You know what I'm saying? You can say that, oh, my goals are stronger than what I want right now. Temptation. My goals are stronger than this current temptation.
Absolutely.
Or, you know, maybe I need to just go and get on my knees and pray and ask for the power to not eat the cookie. Because sometimes it can be strong. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
A lot of those things that we do repeatedly, those cues and those cravings, that's one thing I've learned too. They'll never disappear in your life, you know what I'm saying? That system's already set up in your head and is already established. So It's just making sure that your environment is set up for you to have success. Absolutely. So whether it's like moving it out of the pantry,
absolutely,
or
bro.
The different things that you could do to make sure that you're okay, or maybe saying, hey, maybe I can have a cookie or a couple cookies every once in a while, so it doesn't need to be like your deprivation at a whole another level.
Right, yeah. Right. But the system is set up. Right, there you go. I'm setting up a realistic scenario for yourself versus this unattainable, I'm just going to go cold turkey right now. Like, right. Like I'm a sweets guy. I love donuts. I love ice cream. Like one of my lofty goals for this year, real talk, guys, like, this is just first to y'all knowledge, maybe, and everybody out here. Like, when I get to a point where I'm able to really step away from having to get up and do 9-to-5 stuff, you know, or whatever, 10-to-4, whatever your schedule is, I want to open up an ice cream spot, bro.
Mr. Ice Cream Man.
Like ice cream and donut spot, man. Like, for real. Like, I'm just gonna put it out there. Like, I've always wanted to do that. Like, and do it in the healthiest way. Like, my wife has gotten me into this really good diet, really good, you know, spiritual spot, man. And so, like, when I really quote unquote retire, like, from getting up and just serving everybody, like, I want to be able to do that and have a spot for people to come and just really, you know, be served, man. So that's kind of one of my goals. Like, it's, it could be 2 years from now, it could be 5 years from now, 10 years from now. But I'm saying, like, I've had that in my mind, like, for a while. But like, I'm bringing it back to the topic of the limiting beliefs, right? Like, who's to say that one day I can, you know, have that, you know, and do that? But we put it in our minds, the negative visualizations, mm-hmm. right? Of damn, if I do this, it's gonna go wrong. Versus, we getting here, we was fumbling today, like, all of, like, stuff just happened today, like, you know. Got to the schedule. We tried to get up earlier today to go hiking. My first hike. You know, we got there a little bit later than normal.
Congratulations. Congratulations. That's a steep feat.
Man, but just getting out of your comfort zone, right? Like, I didn't, you know, my wife has been wanting me to do that for a while, and I was really like, what's stopping me? Other than the timing. Like, sometimes we just couldn't do it because of the podcast.
Could have sworn on one of these past episodes I told you about going
on
a hike.
You did. You know what I'm saying?
And I'm just bringing you back.
For sure.
Man.
For sure. But the growth. But the growth.
See, those negative thoughts. Those negative thoughts.
Yeah, man. Come on.
No, but I'm just the time to get up.
But those negative thoughts that he had in the past about us capping on him.
And now look at it. Full circle, man.
And it felt amazing. Like, I promise you.
I just wanted you to feel amazing before.
I know.
You know what I'm
saying?
But hey.
But the limited, you see, the limited thinking. And then the time worked out too as well. Yeah. Like, it really was with time that I really just wanted to go and let her know, I see you. You're growing. Everybody's growing. And we got to step out of our comfort zone, because the more we do it, the easier it gets, man. Like, for real. That's it. Like,
for sure.
Now, the next hike, I mean, it's not going to be as tough, right? I'm in there. I know what to expect. And, I'm not as uncomfortable as I was, you know.
That's the truth, because I could tell you for sure when I, like, the first couple times I sparred, I was flinching. Mm-hmm. Dude, my legs are all jittery. I really was closing my eyes, not trying to see punches, but even then I still revert back sometimes. But I'm a little bit better, a little calmer. I'm seeing punches. I'm moving around, know what to do, able to kind of calm myself down. Yes. But it's a lot. But at the same time, as you said, just the more you do things the right way, the more you get better at the end of the day, because that's how you create mastery, is just doing things repetitive over and over and over again. And that's why we're so prone to do some of the behaviors or the habits that don't serve us, because I'm not calling them bad. Everything should be neutral. You know what I'm saying? It's because we're just so used to doing those things that don't serve us over and over and over again. And we're very good at doing that sometimes.
Definitely. Definitely.
I think unlearning stuff too, right? Like my wife and I, we talked about that too. Just like unlearning and creating different rituals in your life. Like, we have a tea ritual. Like, at night, we try to at least get a tea in, you know what I'm saying? And maybe we get a show. Maybe we get a show, but we at least get a chance to sit down and just kind of just stop, have some tea together. We make sure we touch our glasses together. So tea. We acknowledge, like, for real. Like, I mean, like, I didn't understand, like, how much I needed that until we had that. Like, we just did it like two nights in a row. Like, this has been about a month or two now, but I like that time, right? It's in a setup to win. So now we get a chance to talk to each other. We get a chance to look at each other, drink some tea. And if we hit a show, we hit a show. And if not, you know, she goes to bed, I'm downstairs doing my planning. And then we do it all over again. But setting those different rituals of, let's stop, let's take time to say, hey, I see you, what's up? Like, good day or not? Like, do we want to watch a show? You know, how we feeling?
Now, let's go sleep. It's time to reflect where y'all can connect.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You got to have that time of connection.
Yeah.
And I think that's something that I do too as well, man. And what I meant by being like busy, continue to be busy, is just like always taking on upon myself to push myself to the next limit, man. I've been back in the gym, man, playing ball.
Mm.
So it's been cool to actually get back on the court, man, lace them up again, you know what I'm saying? Some fun to do. And actually, you know what I'm saying, get a little bit of that steam out too as well, because you know what I'm saying? And it also is part of cardio. Every time you don't want to run on the same treadmill, the same thing, you're looking at the same.
That's kind of boring.
So yeah,
that's
exactly.
Kind of boring. Ain't nothing wrong with treadmill runners, you know, Peloton users. But getting out and you get the fresh air in your face, you know, you get some fresh sweat too, you know.
Like, especially because before it was playing hoop with the mask on was not the wave.
Nah, man.
Getting all them fuzzies from your mask where you're trying to breathe, and you know what I'm saying, I understand it's be careful and stuff. So you got to promote that, you know what I'm saying, being careful and doing things on your own time. So if you're not comfortable being out there on the court, you know what I'm saying, come at your own pace.
Yep.
But that one's been because you know that's my safe place, is just being on the court, man, just doing something active. And bettering myself, you know, just to make sure I stay active, you know.
Mm-hmm,
when
mm-hmm.
kids come up and they test me, I can still show them what's going on, you know what I'm saying? But that's been kind of like my thing, and then working on business. And then we also been trying to get into the housing market and understanding that thing is crucial and it's dynamic right now. So I just want to, you know, we just planning on how do we continue to progress and not let the COVID stop the perpetual motion that we have.
Yeah, I think that's why I started to get into boxing a lot more, because it was hard to get those hoop games going, you know.
Yeah.
It was easy for me because I have a hoop close to where I live. I can go shoot around, but that gets kind of stale at the end of the day. I like playing against people. I like testing myself. Mm-hmm. So that was a little bit why I got into boxing, even though it's good to put up shots and do those different drills or whatever it may be. But I do miss it. I still play occasionally. We'll warm up playing and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I haven't lost all of it. I still got a little something in the tank. So it's been kind of fun. And I think eventually I'll probably get out back out there again, too.
Because
I'd rather do that than just run, you know. Something running on the treadmill, just running just to run, is something that is very difficult for me at this time. It's very mentally taxing, mentally draining, but that's why I have a lot of respect for distance runners, because you got to be mentally strong and what you're telling yourself and the breathing. So there's a lot that goes into that as well too.
And also got an idea for us to, like, man, one day let's get out on the bike as well, man. Just a way to kind of embrace the natural air that's out there and purify and, you know, fresh, clean air, especially in Washington State, man. Just all surrounded by the Evergreen State, you know.
That's important.
We got a lot of paths and stuff around the areas and the neighborhoods, so let's take advantage of that, because that's definitely another
way.
Across
that bridge.
Didn't know, you know what I'm saying? And, like, coming from Chicago, like, I was telling my wife as we were driving back, I'm like, I never knew.
I was on the bike, man, but I had the pegs and the monoblocks on that old Huffy, you know what I'm saying? I could before, man, but I don't know about right now. I don't know.
Don't do it, man.
Exactly. Exactly. I make a business decision and not do that right now. Embarrass myself, but maybe if I get behind them handlebars, we'll see. Stay tuned to GMH Radio.
Be like, well, I'm coming from the hospital. Here we are.
I'm going to go out of my comfort zone and say that I don't belong in that place. And, hey, on the mountain bike is where I be. I might need an electric bike.
Hey, they out there. We saw, like, those electric scooters, man. They get up, man. Yeah. They was out there on the streets with people. On the street with people, though, going, like, 30, 40 miles an hour.
Yeah.
I be seeing people doing that. They be two grown men on one.
Oh, no. You can't be, you know, hopping a ride on back with my scooter now.
That's not something.
But speaking of that, I mean,
that's two out of my comfort zone, for real.
Yeah. But gas getting high.
That defeats the workout. That's why I like the bike, you know what I'm saying? You get the pedal in, you get the motion in. On the scooter, I feel like, you know, unless you out there with the old scooter, you know, 1 foot, you know what I'm saying? Then kick, push.
Kids out there on that wheel, man, they still got that thing that was blowing up and stuff. That was like, you just on the wheel. Like, I first saw that, I'm like, what is going on? Like, we ain't walking nowhere. We ain't doing no type of calisthenics.
No more.
Like, come on. We got the wheel. That's it. One wheel and some foot pedestals. That's all you got.
That junk look like it's hard, too. Now they have a lot of these pedal bikes, too, that you don't even have to pedal that much. They're kind of automatic. Either they're solar powered.
Oh,
that's what I'm talking about with them electric joints, man.
Oh, like, okay. So, once again, I love tech, but like, don't get to the point where like it takes away from the actual
experience. People like them, man.
No, that's fine. I'm just impartial to like, let me be physical with, let me actually put into.
But you can still peddle it as you want. It's just gonna help you if you need it. It's there to help. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be open to that, man. It's there to help you.
Okay, so stay there for the ones that just take the little bit of help. What about the ones that they relied on the tech, then they go out. Now they don't have no type of skills to actually pedal the bike. So this is a metaphor, right? Like the proverbial life metaphor of pedaling the bike. I got a little bit of help versus I got to pedal this thing myself. In a pinch, what if the help go out?
Yeah, right. Especially with the cars too. Yeah. A lot of people don't know how to drive, so they just putting a little autopilot on.
Yeah.
I know you ain't doing that all the time, I'm saying? But at the same time, a lot of people we're going to have a lot of non-driving people out there.
Yeah, that's true.
They don't know what to do.
Autopilot. How many people got their life on autopilot, bro?
Yeah.
How many people got I just thought about, like, come on. You don't take the steering wheel or nothing, and then you expect to go where you want to go?
Yeah.
At all, you don't touch it. You don't just let it, just look at it. And all this glory around you, this glorious technology, you let it just take you where you want to go.
It's a two-way street, though, because, you know, you let it take you where you want to go safely, because the car built to do that. You know, I don't think it'd be out there if it wasn't able to. And then I think the bike still operates as a normal bike. And, yeah, if you can't do it, then you got to do your due diligence to understand your what-if scenarios and scenario planning like we talked about. So you got to take it upon yourself to go out there and do the research to see if you're capable of being on this bike or being in this type of ride or being, you know what I'm saying? What do you feel comfortable with? And at the end of the day, you the consumer, you buy what you want. If you wanted to have that capability, you can. If you don't, then that's what it is.
The power is yours. The
power is yours. You control your destiny.
Like Captain Planet.
Yeah, go planet.
Man. That I used to watch that on like what Saturday morning cartoons and stuff.
Earth, Wind, Fire. Yeah. Earth, Wind, Fire.
Heart. And then it ain't like that. It's not like Thanos. Right? I'm thinking like
you're the whole another cartoon. All right,
thinking like Thanos. Next, man. No, but it's like fire, wind, water, heart.
Earth. Fire, wind, water, heart.
Earth,
Wind,
and
Fire. That's what I'm like, wait, I know about Earth, Wind, and Fire. Like, is that what it is?
That's a real
Captain Planet. Hey, we talking about Captain Planet. No, but growing up, man, I never thought that we would be like where we are now, man, just as a society. Like, we talk about being uncomfortable, right? Like, just having to stay home with people, like, that you never thought that you would have to stay home with. Like, that's uncomfortable in itself, and having to deal with yourself.
It's just interesting, like, just to understand, like, the generation that we are in and the things that we've experienced from, like, pandemics to terrorist attacks to
gas going up
to whatever, you know, just the things that we've experienced over our time being here is just wonders, like, the trajectory we're going and just being aware. And that's why we, you know what I'm saying, we come here to have these conversations and have these dialogue between each other just to understand what type of path or what type of way you're thinking. Because, like, you know what I'm saying, all the time, it doesn't have to align, but understanding and being able to have the conversations where it's like, this is my perspective versus yours, it gets to the point where now I'm intrigued to go deeper and to think deeper into what someone else is capable of doing, and then that'll help broaden my way of learning, you know, because you might be stuck in the way of just how you think and operate. And that's a conversation that me and Tasha are continuing to expand on and grow from, is just having the times where we can understand different dynamic situations and dynamic thoughts and how that comes together and how we use those to, you know, build a stronger bond and build stronger relationships going forward. And and then us as well, just being able to, we got a myriad of different ways of thinking and how we apply that, like continuing to build this podcast and continuing to put content out and continuing to meet together. And I see the growth that we all are able to do into different realms and different things and the way we're doing things. We're just continuing to grow. Like, I never thought that we'd be here and now we're doing it. And when I say doing it, I'm intending to do it instead of trying. Because trying, I heard Ed Britton from Hot Boxing Podcast with Mike Tyson, he just said that trying is the active verb of not doing. Like, you're not doing something.
Wow.
He's focused on the doing.
Wow.
What does it take to do it versus just the trying?
Yeah. No, that's real. And I mean, we've all had our times where we were just like you said, trying. And I think, like you said, we've been able to see that growth and help each other continue to move, you know, continue to take action. You know, like we talk a lot of crap to each other, you know what I'm saying? But in jest, I know that's how we get each other to go and have fun and just really, you know, make light of it, because sometimes we'll make it more than what it is, you know? And I think that's where, like I said, we talked about those limiting thoughts, that, you know, visualization of negativity versus, man, I see myself like, you know, three CEOs up here. It's three founders. It's three, you know what I'm saying? It's three different, you know, imaginations. And that takes, I think for us, it takes, you know, art and skill to be able to continuously maneuver together, you know, with the big imaginations that we all have, right? Like, I gotta say that I appreciate you guys, man, and I mean that from my heart, like, because I look out here and I see teams that are just blowing up, you know what I'm saying? Like, they just, I don't know, like, they would look like a good team, and then boom, like, this pandemic happened, or just the Lakers. Things happened. Like, okay.
I'm sorry, I had to do it.
But somebody had a vision for that squad. And I mean, whether it worked out or not, they're going to learn from that, and they're going to take on other ventures and do it. But we've been able to, like I said, I think really maneuver with grace and really, you know, like I said, we jab and we needle, but that's really to say, come on, man, I see you. You know what I'm saying? I see you. Like, come on, let's not take it serious as we think it might be right now. Like, keep going.
And what you were saying about that would kind of hit home about, it's not about trying, it's about doing. And I think that is a mentality and mind shift change to say that I am doing something. You're not trying, you are actively doing it, but maybe you're not doing it to the best of your ability. You can go back and see what you're not doing or what needs to, or what you are doing, what's good, what you're not doing, that's not good enough. And then, you know, you continue to do, don't continue to try.
Mm-hmm. But that's tough for folks. I mean, most people, and I'm just generalizing here, it's more of a, I see it, and for whatever reason, like, I've been told my whole life I can't do it, you know what I'm saying? And that in itself is a hard cycle to break out of if you don't have the right tools.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I think one thing we talk about here is really, you know, having a team, you know, having the right tools, the right support system around you. So like when you get into those negative feedback loops, you know, we talk about, you can just say, hey, come on, what you doing? Come on, we got to go this way. You know, just like up the trail. Like, I mean, just great metaphor. Like, it was tough, man. That shit was tough, bro. Yeah. I mean, I wanted to give up. There, absolutely. That's what I was going with. And they were like, come on, babe, let's go.
And then you were that then as well to them. If they thought the same thing.
Yeah.
You'd have decided a factor to say, okay, I'm going to push myself. And then you were into your doing it phase.
Yep, mm-hmm. Yep,
you know what I'm saying?
Got up there and it was beautiful. You know, it was beautiful, man. It was really tough. I ain't going to lie.
Which trail did you do?
So that was Tiger Mountain, I think. They call it Poo Poo Trail.
Poo Poo Point?
Poo Poo Point. So I think it was the Tiger Mountain, I think folks would know, from Pacific Northwest. And so it was beautiful, man. It's in our backyard. And like I said, I had yet to experience that. And it was amazing, man. And I really, it was fun, one of those moments where I had to coach myself and go like, see, you keep going, man. Like, because you would have robbed yourself of that experience with my wife and my son and his girlfriend was there. You know, so that was a special moment for me.
Generation, man.
They might not know it until they hear the cast, but like, I literally was just like, wow, like, look at that, man. Like, man, like, that's growth. You know what I'm saying? Seeing my son there, like, living his life, you know, and being able to bring her along. So it's like, it continues to motivate me, you know. It's not a demotivator for me to see somebody going, you know, going, doing well. And I think that's why I know we bond in such a great way, because I want you to do well, because if you do well, I know I'm gonna do well, because my boys got my back. And so I think in a selfish way, I try to be as selfless as I can, especially with my crew, my team, bro. Like, y'all don't see me break down, y'all don't see me at my worst, my best, you know. And so that's it. I mean, I think that's what, you know, you have to be out of your comfort zone to really achieve that big life and that big goal that you're setting for yourself.
Yeah, and you can say that people haven't been told to do it, but I would argue that they're not looking at the signs, because Nike is continually, and everybody says, saying, just do it, and that's always there, but you don't really think about it like that, too.
Mm.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Simple actions.
On that note, man, we're going to continue to do it.
Yes, absolutely.
We're going to continue to bring you the content. We're going to continue to plan it out and bring you more from 2CGMH. And we're going to sign out. It's your boy P-Wil, Mr. Feelgood.
It's your boy WB. Come fly with me. Because you can't fly for free.
It's your boy Al-Diga, the architect. Still building together, man. Love y'all, man. Appreciate it.